Tennessee fans, I'm Cassandra Novi, and you're watching Lady Vol Access, an inside look at Lady Vol basketball. On this week's show, we'll get to know graduate assistant Josh Baney, and then we'll catch up with one of this year's leaders, junior guard Megan Simmons. As a former practice player and aspiring coach, graduate assistant Josh Baney is looking to make the most out of his Tennessee experience. Let's get to know him in this week's Meet the Staff.
Hey, I'm Josh Baney. I'm the graduate assistant at the University of Tennessee. My role for the women's basketball team is mainly with recruiting, developing flyers, and making sure they're going out to the right kids. I work alongside with Dean Lockwood in getting the practice players, through compliance and making sure that they're at practice. And during the games, we have our managers as well as myself. We take stats for the games, whether it's like charges, could be deflections, different things that aren't on the regular stat sheet. I had an opportunity to be the assistant coach at Lambeth University, men's, and took that job and gained a lot of valuable experience through that. And then I decided I wanted to get my graduate degree. So. Spring of last year, I was accepted into the sport management program. So all last semester, I volunteered my time and was fortunate enough for a graduate assistant position to open up, was able to take that opportunity. Well, one of the big things about when I was a practice player, which kind of shocked me, was Pat came up to me and asked me a question, like trying to get advice on how the girls were doing. And I was a college student, loving the game of basketball, and I just thought that was unbelievable that Pat would ask advice, from someone like me. Just shows how much she is constantly learning about the game. Being around the staff and the team, they're a great group of people, always joking around. Now, when it's game time and it's serious time, everybody's serious, but it's I couldn't ask to be a part of any better staff than this. There's just something about Knoxville, being a part of Knoxville, and everywhere you go, you see the university and people recognize you around town as being part of a prestigious program, prestigious university, let alone the Tennessee Lady Vols.
Well, it's no secret that the Lady Vols are a young team this year, causing some players to step up. Let's take a look to see how Megan Simmons is taking charge.
Tennessee's Megan Simmons doesn't wait for the game to come to her. She attacks with energy and emotion.
McDaniel with a rebound, comes over to Bannister. She lost it. Simmons picks it up. 2-on-2, Simmons pulls up, free throw line, jumper is good.
I have always been energetic. I have six siblings, so I mean, we were always, out trying to do something, and I was always the one who was always trying to run around and be outside, and I'm one of those girls that wanted to be in the dirt and play around with the guys and things like that. So I think, that kind of, brings a lot more energy out of me, and I have the tendency to be fast all the time, so it's just one of those things that, just comes with me.
After playing point guard as a freshman, number 10 has settled into the two-guard role on Holly Warlick's Lady Vols.
My freshman year, I was, thrown into a position that I never really had played before. And it caused me and it forced me to be a leader because I was the point guard. My sophomore year, I was, kind of going back and forth between the one and the two because we ended up having another point guard. So this year, I'm a junior, so as years pass on, I'm going to have to step up and do more, especially since next year, I will be the only senior next year. I have to do a lot more. I have to be a leader by example, which is working hard every day in practice and communicating all the time.
on a team with few upperclassmen, the junior has embraced the expectation of leadership.
She's having to be the person that people look to, not just for scoring-wise, but for advice. And during practice, she's being more vocal. And, you know, she's really telling everybody what we need to do instead of just sitting aside and just letting things play out. So I really admire her being, like, stepping up and stepping to that junior leadership role that we need her to be.
Through all her successes at Tennessee, Simmons is just focused on the next play because there is nothing else she can control.
My expectation for this season is to become a better person, each and every game, learning from every single mistake, making sure that, at any point in time, this basketball could be taken away from me and, not taking anything for granted during the season and making sure I'm constantly giving my 110% and making sure I just get better every single day. And, I'm grateful that I can be in the history books of Tennessee because when I came here, I wanted to be a part of the tradition. And I feel like me being in the history books is me being a part of something that is a humongous tradition amongst women's basketball. And that's just something that means a lot to me, to be under the Pat Summitt aura and still be, in the history books. A part of that, I think, is an amazing feeling. But I just don't ever take anything for granted and be grateful for everything.
Well, as 2012 comes to a close, so does this week's episode. Be sure to check out the Lady Vols as they play Rutgers on December 30th. Tennessee will ring in the New Year's by taking on SEC foe South Carolina on January 3rd in Columbia. Both games will air on Sports South. Thanks so much for joining us, and we wish you a Happy New Year.